In our previous video, we covered the basics of moving shapes around in Tinkercad. Now let's learn how to add and subtract basic shapes to create a simple design. First, we need to think about what we want to make and take any measurements if needed. Let's say we want to design a simple wrench with a handle. We can start by dragging a box shape from the right toolbar onto the work plane to create the handle for the wrench. To resize the box, we can use the resize handles like we demonstrated in our previous video. With the shape selected, look for the shape dialog window located towards the middle of your screen. The shape dialog window contains additional properties to further modify your shape. For instance, for our box shape, we can add a radius to smooth out sharp edges. Let's go ahead and add a small radius to the box so that the handle will be a little bit more comfortable to hold. To do that, in the shape dialog window, we can click and drag the radius slider or click to type in a number. Now let's add a cylinder shape. Resize and position it so it slightly overlaps and blends into the first shape. We need the two shapes to overlap some in order to combine them. To combine two shapes, select the first shape and then hold down Shift and click the second shape. Click the Group button in the top menu to merge the two shapes together. If you make a mistake, you can click the Ungroup button to break them apart. When you're done, don't forget to group them again to combine them. You can also subtract shapes to create holes and cutouts. Let's drag out a polygon shape to create a cutout for our wrench. To convert a solid shape into a hole, select the shape and in the shape dialog window, click the hole icon to change it from a solid to a hole. The shape will become transparent, indicating it can now cut through other shapes. We need the hole to overlap with the solid shape to create a cutout. Resize and position it so it slightly overlaps our previous shape. To subtract one shape from another, select the whole shape and then hold down Shift and click the solid shape. Now click the Group button in the top menu to finalize the cut. Like before, you can always click Ungroup if you need to fix a mistake. And now we have our finished wrench. From here, you can click Export and download an STL file for 3D printing. Now that you know the basics, take some time to explore the different shapes in the right toolbar and then try creating your own design. Thanks for watching!